Hi, I'm Estelle. I had gastric bypass with Dr. Singh March 22nd of 2010, so it's almost 2 years ago now. I know when I was first investigating this and I saw post-op patients standing up here, it's hard for me to picture them being overweight. So I did bring a couple of before and after photos, which I'll pass around. One in particular is just before pictures, and then I also have a comparison of me wearing similar outfits before and after. The reason I decided to have the surgery was I kind of felt like I was living life on the sidelines. I just felt like my quality of life was really poor. I wasn't maybe as obese as a lot of other patients that I've seen that had the surgery, but enough that I didn't feel good about myself. I was really concerned about my health. I didn't have major health issues, but I had gone through 5 years of infertility treatment because I had had polycystic ovarian syndrome, and my reproductive endocrinologist had said, you will get diabetes. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. I tried, you know, different diet plans like other people have as well, and I'd never been very successful, maybe 15 pounds max on one occasion, and then try again another occasion, 15 pounds, and I always gained it back. The reason that I really wanted to have the surgery was because I was worried that even if I was successful losing a large amount of weight, that I wouldn't keep it off long term. I wanted to have a tool, as Dr. Singh and Dr. Linson were talking about. And that's really what this is, it's a tool. I also am very compliant with the program, but I have bad days. And when I have a bad day, I'm really grateful that I have this tool. I still have to decide to eat the right foods, but I'm limited in how much I can eat in a sitting. And that's huge, because like I said, on my bad days, they're not as bad as they would have been pre-op. The reason I chose Albany Medical Center was when I talked to my primary physician, she absolutely positively wanted me to come to Albany Medical Center. She said that they had the best reputation, they were center of excellence, and I said, well, how about if I go to their educational session, but I also check out some other programs so that I can determine for myself whether or not I feel like I want to go there. And she said, okay, as long as you check out Albany Med and you compare. So I went to the Albany Med educational session first, and I learned a lot. And then I went to another educational session, and I thought, okay, where's the rest? Where's the rest of the education? What I learned was informative. And it seemed pretty thorough, except that I had already heard so much more information at my Albany Med educational session. And it frightened me that I could maybe go into a program and feel confident in what I heard, but not know what I didn't know, not know what I wasn't hearing. And the thing about the Albany Med program was that I felt like the more people that told me, oh, there's so much red tape, there's so many hoops to jump through, the more confident I felt in the program. Well, then they're looking at everything. There's no potential issues that are going to come up that they're not going to have made me address. And so when I went into surgery, I felt very prepared. One of the requirements was going to a support group. And we were required to go to two support groups. And I waited until I had completed most of my requirements before I went to any. And when I went, I thought, what took me so long to come to support group? Because it's not just about support, it's about knowledge in support group. And the support aspect of it is really important as well. But I learned so much about what to expect. And sometimes I would hear things that I didn't think pertained to me. And then after surgery, things would come up and I would think, oh, I know about this, I know what to do, I heard what to do. Plus I made connections with people that I could reach out to ask questions of and just be there for support. I've become a regular weekly member of support group. We're fortunate to have a group that meets every week. as well as having a separate group for people that have had the surgery at least a year ago, which is helpful because your issues kind of change. But I find it still important for me to go to the support group that that people who are just starting to investigate the program go to as well, not just for myself, but to pay it forward. There were a lot of people I sort of looked up to when I was going to support group, and had they not been there, I wouldn't have gotten to see the image of, you know, what life might look like afterwards. The other nice thing I like about support group is that we've started to support each other outside of the support group meeting, through a variety of ways, through a Facebook page where you can ask questions or just talk about your feelings at any time of day or night. And we also do activities. A lot of times there are activities that help promote healthy lifestyle, things like going on walks. We did a trip to Adirondack Extreme Ropes Course. It's an aerial ropes course. And there were some people that physically weren't able to do that activity, but because we're a support group, people came and participated, people came and cheered, people came and did what they could, and there was a lot of talk about respecting your limitations. So if you could only do a small portion of the course, everybody was cheering for you, and those same people who were not able to complete the course were cheering for the people that could. So I feel that there's support no matter where you are in the program. I started exercising pretty early out after surgery. I wasn't doing really much exercise before surgery. I did lose more than the minimum 10% before surgery, and that was because I followed the diet that I was going to have to follow after surgery, and that was based on meeting with the nutritionist telling me what diet to follow. Not only did it help me lose weight, but it really prepared me for the diet I was going to have to follow for the rest of my life. I remember thinking a few weeks after surgery, this is really hard. It's really hard to eat this way when I don't feel like it. But thank goodness I'm already used to it, because if I hadn't already been eating this way for several months before surgery, I can't imagine how much harder it would be. So I felt that was just one more example of how I was well prepared going into surgery. I mentioned I started exercising. I decided that running was going to be my thing, and I started very slowly. There's a program that a lot of people start when they want to do running, and it's called Couch to 5K. And you start the program by running for 60 seconds, and I thought I was going to die running for 60 seconds. And since that time, I have been running consistently. My first goal was to participate in a relay race with 12 other women. It was a 200-mile, two-day relay race. And this is somebody who, you know, started out, I have lost a total of 105 pounds, so I started out that much heavier and, you know, had a plan. And little by little, as I lost the weight, the running got easier. I did participate in that run, and I'm currently starting to train for this year's version of the run. I wanted to pass around some photos of things that I can do now that I couldn't do before. This is all about lifestyle change. Yes, I've lost the weight. But I'm really focused on being physically fit and healthy. Some of the things that I've done, I did a triathlon, I've done kayaking, I've gotten into hula hooping for fitness, rock climbing, rollerblading, all sorts of things. And not only has it kept me fit, but it's really improved my quality of life. Not only am I doing this with friends, but I have a young child who I hated going outside and playing with her because she didn't have a playmate. All she had was me. And you'll see a picture in that group of pictures where I was at a road race, and I was waiting for it to start, and she and I were just warming up, just running in the parking lot. And I feel like not only am I getting to have fun with her, but I'm role modeling for her. I'm teaching her. What else did I want to say? The other thing is I feel not only more fit, but I feel younger. Oddly enough, I've been running into people that I haven't seen since high school recently, and that's been about 30 years, and people are recognizing me like that instantly. And yet, I run into people that I haven't seen in 2 years, and they don't know who I am. I went to a wedding recently. It was my in-laws, my husband's family, and so, you know, they know me, but they didn't know me before I gained weight, or they didn't know me before I, you know, gained some of my weight. And several family members walked up to me and said, I had no idea who you were until you started talking, or, you know, I wondered who that woman was that your husband was with. They would have expected it to be me, but I looked so much different they didn't recognize me. And I feel like I look younger, I feel younger. I went to my doctor for my yearly physical recently, and I had to fill out new paperwork. And I looked at the boxes to check off, and I checked off excellent for health. And I stopped and thought, I don't even think when I was a college student I could have checked off that my health was excellent. And it felt so good to not only have lost the weight, but, you know, to be in excellent health.